We have a remarkable diversity of butterflies in Hong Kong, 250, 260. The numbers may be increasing, in fact.
This number is pretty high compared to many cities in the world, likely because Hong Kong is located at a subtropical location. It's surrounded by a lot of mountains and protected areas, which allow them to breed around the city.
It's really something that we have a number of species in such a small space and that we've been able to protect them so far.
Butterflies are a really perfect indicator for other insects. Not necessarily because they're behaving exactly like other insects, but because we see them, we notice them, they're conspicuous.
I'm a member of Danaid Butterfly Research Hong Kong, which is a group of scientists and volunteers who are studying the migratory and seasonal movements of Danaid butterflies here in Asia. Danaids globally are known for their migratory behaviors. We have a number of Danaids here in Hong Kong, and we're investigating whether or not they actually engage in migrations in this part of the world.
It's really the underlying mystery of whether these Danaid butterflies are migrating, where they're migrating, how they're migrating. That's what we really want to understand.
We're looking at three different kinds of Danaids: crow butterflies, which are brown, orange tigers, which are orange and black, and blue tigers, which are brown and blue. We've added an additional element in our study in that we're trying to incorporate public participation. Thanks everyone for coming out to be with us today. Everyone is going to participate in butterfly tagging. You all get to put stickers on them and release them. We're placing stickers made of paper with a little bit of wax on them on butterfly wings. Each sticker has an individual butterfly code and a URL at which the public can report their sightings of the butterflies. This one is ready to be released, so when we release it, we hold it just like this, and then you just open your fingers and drop them and they fly away.
It's very important to do events like this to get the public to know more about the research, because I think in Hong Kong, people don't know much about local biodiversity, but there's actually a lot to see and discover in Hong Kong.
It's really difficult for us to collect all the data that we need on our own. So public reports are really crucial for collecting data across Hong Kong on butterfly movement, on longevity, on their location, and you are a crucial participant in this research.
Having public participation in this project is very important, because we need citizen scientists to help report the sightings of tagged butterflies over Hong Kong.
What we're asking individuals to do is to go to our website and upload a photo through a specified submission form that provides the location using a Google map of where they've taken the photo or where they are at the time of reporting.
We observed movement of two butterflies of 17 kilometers to and from South Lantau to a site in Thailand. And it was two different species. So it really indicates that there is a lot of diversity in the movement of these animals.
We have over 250 photos that individuals have submitted. And these are indicating that butterflies are moving within Hong Kong, but we don't have any evidence that they're moving outside of Hong Kong from tagging locations within the territory. South Lantau has a number of diverse and intact natural habitats that we're finding these Danaid butterflies in. We suspect that if these butterflies are leaving Hong Kong and in their migration, Lantau is probably the last stop that many of them are visiting along their westward movement.
We're working with the government, we're working with NGOs, we're working with schools, we're working with the community, communicating all of our findings to everyone, because we do think and know that it's important that everyone is aware of the existence of these butterflies and where they're going.
The ultimate goal for this project is to get public reports of our butterflies outside of Hong Kong so we can identify the spaces along their migratory routes and their destination, so we can identify areas necessary for preservation of these species and the phenomena of migration.
We have lots of migratory species, but if we can track and understand how the Danaids are migrating, then hopefully we can understand how to conserve other species that are migratory as well.
Hong Kong has a diversity of natural habitats that butterflies rely on. The more that we can preserve these habitats and the host plants and nectar plants that they rely on, the better we'll be able to preserve their populations and preserve this amazing phenomenon of migration that insects engage in.